In October, we'll be able to photograph the full moon, the Orionids Meteor Shower, the Milky Way and the Galactic Center, the Zodiacal Light, and yes, October is a fantastic month to photograph the Zodiacal Light, the Crescent Moon, Mercury at its greatest eastern elongation, and five conjunctions of the moon with the planets, with Saturn, Jupiter, Venus, Mars, and Mercury. Also, as always, at the end of the video, I'm going to share with you three of the best photos that you guys have submitted to the PhotoPills Awards and that will be featured in September. The full moon is on October 7th, giving us another great opportunity to photograph it aligning with an interesting subject. So, based on the moonrise and moonset directions, plan your moonshot. For instance, if on October 7th, 2025 at 7:55 a.m. I am at the red pin position here in Minorca, I'll be able to see how the full moon is setting aligned with the Punta Nati lighthouse, which is an incredible lighthouse. The moon size will be pretty big. You have the moon size in brackets on the top panel. Size is 7.1 meters, which is pretty cool. The moon height is 8.3 meters, which is the height of the center of the moon above the terrain where the lighthouse is. So it will be more or less at the same height as the lighthouse. And the shot occurs in golden hour. The sun elevation is 1.16 degrees, which means the sun is rising and it's a golden hour. So the moon will start to catch up a bit of yellow color. Something like this shot Antoni Gloria took, where you see the moon setting above Punta Nati lighthouse. What do you think? Do you like this shot? Let me know in the comments. And by the way, if you used to learn how to plan your moonshots, watch this video. The Orionids Meteor Shower is peaking on the night that goes from October 20th to the 21st, or from October 21st to the 22nd, depending on where you are on Earth. And the good news is that this year the peak occurs around new moon, so we don't have to worry about the moon. According to a top panel, for the red pin position, I had the red pin near Fabaric Lighthouse in Menorca, the peak is on October 21st at 6:06 a.m. and the expected meteor shower rate is 80 meteors per hour, which is pretty cool. This meteor shower is visible from both hemispheres, so get ready to photograph it. The new moon is on October 21st. And October is the last month we'll be able to see the Milky Way and the Galactic Center together. So let's take advantage of it. In the Northern Hemisphere, it's a great time to photograph Milky Way when it's completely vertical and with the Galactic Center visible in the southwest directions. If I tap on the AR button, you'll see how vertical it is. The Milky Way, I have the horizon here, this is the Galactic Center. I have the moon, it's new moon below the horizon. And the Milky Way is completely vertical. You can get the Milky Way in pretty vertical compositions in the Northern Hemisphere. Let's go to the Southern Hemisphere. For instance, we've been in Namibia in the Skeleton Coast exploring the Milky Way and this amazing land here in Namibia, which is what an adventure, I gotta say. And here in October, in the Skeleton Coast, in the Southern Hemisphere, in Namibia, you can get the Milky Way when it's pretty low in the sky, in the west, Let me tap on the AR button. And if you imagine that you're in Namibia in the Skeleton Coast, you have here the horizon, the Milky Way arch appears here. Here we have the core Milky Way, super high in the sky, as always. And here we have the other crossing point with the horizon, and this is the South Celestial Pole, the equivalent of the North Celestial Pole in the Northern Hemisphere. So October is another great month to photograph the Milky Way from both hemispheres. And if you still learn how to plan your Milky Way shots, watch this video. Also in October, around new moon, it's a great time to photograph the Zodiacal Light. And you know that the Zodiacal Light is the reflection produced due to the scattering of sunlight due to the particles moving in the entire solar system. In the Northern Hemisphere, in October, the Zodiacal Light is visible in the east before dawn, before the astronomical twilight begins in the morning, in the direction of sunrise, the thick yellow line you see here on the map. On the contrary, in the Southern Hemisphere, is visible in the direction of sunset, after the astronomical twilight ends. And if you look in the sunset direction, the thick orange line you see here on the map, you'll see the Zodiacal Light there. So planning your Zodiacal Light shots with the sunrise and sunset directions is pretty straightforward. Give it a try. 1, 2, or 3 days before or after the new moon is a great time to photograph the crescent moon when it's super thin, when the moon is thin with a phase of 1, 2, 3%, 4%. For instance, check this plan if on October 23rd, 2025 at 7:18 p.m. I am at the red pin position here in Menorca, I'll be able to photograph the crescent moon setting over Ciutadella, my hometown, and very close to the Cathedral of Ciutadella, which is pretty cool. The moon, you have it on panel number 3, the phase will be 4.5% as waxing crescent, and the elevation of the sun is minus 5.61, which means that the natural light will be at the end of blue hour, which is pretty cool. You can plan your crescent moon shots in the same way you plan your full moon shots. And if you wish to learn how to plan and focus crescent moon, watch this video. On October 29th, Mercury will be at its greatest eastern elongation, which means that the planet will be further away from the sun, giving us great conditions to view it and photograph it. Mercury will shine in the evening skies with a magnitude of minus 0.7, which means that the planet will be visible to the naked eye. You know that celestial bodies that have a magnitude under 6 are visible to the naked eye. So after sunset, you'll find it low in the sky, very close to the sunset direction, which is the thick orange line you see here on the map. You can't miss it. In October, there'll be 5 moon planet conjunctions. On October 6th, the moon will be in conjunction with Saturn, and the moon phase will be 98%. Pretty full. On October 13th, the moon will be in conjunction with Jupiter, and the moon phase will be 48%. On October 19th, Venus will be in conjunction with the moon, and the moon will be pretty thin. The moon phase will be only 2.4%. And on October 23rd, Mercury and Mars will be in conjunction with the moon, and the moon phase will be 3.9%. On both hemispheres, you'll find the moon planet conjunctions where the moon is, and you know that in PhotoPills, the moon direction is represented by this thin line that's moving when I change the time. So where you see the moon, there you'll find also the planets. Now let's see some of the best photos that you submitted to the PhotoPills Awards and that we featured in September. The first one is a fantastic Milky Way over the desert of Al Qua in UAE, photo taken by Thwaip and Hum. The second photo is a cool Manhattan hinge aligned with the crescent moon, taken from New Jersey, USA, photo taken by Mike Carroll. And the third one is a beautiful photo of a pair of storks against the sun in Cordoba, Spain, photo taken by Pedro Mengual. Thank you for sharing, guys, amazing photos. And now you should learn how to plan and photograph each one of the events I've shared in this video. I invite you to download and study well our super detailed astronomical events photography guide. I'm gonna leave a link to the guide in the description of this video and in the first comment below. Download it. And as always, if you like this video, give me a like, subscribe, and I'll see you next Wednesday in another video. Remember that you have the power to imagine, plan, and shoot legendary photos. Bye.